Hello everyone, this is Oxhorn, and in this video we're going to be talking about the quest Blind Betrayal, which contains major, major plot spoilers, having to do with the Brotherhood of Steel story and the fate of Paladin Dance. So if you don't want any spoilers, turn back now. Last chance, you have been warned. After you convince either Dr. Lee or Professor Skara to go to the Brotherhood of Steel and work on Liberty Prime, you get word that Elder Maxon needs to speak with you immediately. The Brotherhood has finally decoded the intel that you secured from the Institute, and what they learned is very troubling.
Proctor Quinlan completed the decryption of the data you retrieved from the Institute. A portion of his findings included a list of synths that went missing or escaped from their underground facility. Paladin Dance is a perfect match for one of the synths on that list. The data you brought back included a record of each subject's DNA. We keep the same information on file for all of our soldiers. Paladin Dance's DNA is a perfect match for a synth they called M797. Dance is a synth. He represents everything we hate. A monstrosity of technology. Our mission in the Commonwealth is clear. The Institute and its creations need to be destroyed in order to preserve our future. Which leaves me facing the most difficult order I've ever given. I'm ordering you to hunt down Dance and execute him.
There must be some other way.
Exactly. You're not willing to let off one innocent man?
What he asks is just wrong. Monsieur Dance is our friend.
I don't know what to say.
Come on, you're better than that. You don't go turning on your friends just because someone orders you to.
Some people may have a problem with missions like this. You know, friends of ours.
You will do it. This is not up for judgment or debate. I'm giving you a direct order, Knight, and I expect you to follow it without question.
So Paladin Dance is a synth. Now, the way you, the player, and as a consequence, the sole survivor, responds to this information will have a lot to do with whether or not you buy the idea that synths can be people, or if you instead buy the idea that synths are just machines, and as machines, that they are dangerous. As tough as this quest is, the good thing about it is it forces you to confront the consequences of believing that synths are just machines, that they're worth little more than, as Proctor Quinlan puts it, a toaster or a ham radio.
Sorry about this business with Dance.
He'll be missed.
Doubtful. I wouldn't miss a synth any sooner than I'd miss a transistor radio. I was merely sorry that you'd been duped. No matter.
Proctor Quinlan tells us a little bit more about how he discovered that Paladin Dance was a synth.
While I was decrypting all of the data you acquired from within the Institute, I came across a list. As I was perusing this list, I came across an image of Dance under the heading M797. A quick DNA comparison with our own records told the rest of the tale.
Okay, so he saw a terminal entry. He saw Paladin Dance's photo next to a synth's name. Elder Maxon tells us that they compared Paladin Dance's DNA with the DNA sample that came with the data from the Institute, and they found a match. But how do we know that this wasn't staged by the Institute? How can we trust the information that we got from the Institute? After all, couldn't the Institute have gotten a hold of some of the Brotherhood's private records, and then, in an attempt to weaken the Brotherhood of Steel, falsely put reports in their own data saying that some of the top leaders of the Brotherhood, like Paladin Dance, were really synths, knowing that if this was ever found out by the Brotherhood, that it would harm them. As you continue to talk with Proctor Quinlan, Scribe Halen comes in, indignant.
What the hell is this crap about Dance being a synth?
I don't like your tone, Halen.
My tone? Who cares about protocol at a time like this? I can't believe that after everything Paladin Dance did for you, you're just gonna turn your back on him like this.
Scribe Halen! You're addressing a senior officer, and you will show her the respect that she's due. Or so help me, I'll have you brought up on charges.
My apologies, Proctor. I believe I have some information that's relevant to the search.
Very well, then. Would you care to enlighten us? Or do we have to wait until you decide to grace us with your knowledge?
Knight, if you'd accompany me to the flight deck, I'd like to show you the information I've compiled firsthand.
Change of heart, Halen?
Just following orders. Ma'am.
If you follow her to the bottom of the main deck, she does her best to urge you to not execute Paladin Dance.
I've known Paladin Dance ever since I was an initiate. He trained me, showed me the ropes, and when I screwed up, he taught me to dust myself off and move on. He's earned my admiration, my respect, And my friendship.
And then she says what I think is one of the most powerful lines from this quest.
I don't care if he's a machine or not. He's still Dance.
Human or machine, he's Dance. She's gotten to know Dance. Her life is better because of Dance. She's grown as a professional and as a human being because of her relationship with Paladin Dance. Those things are real. Those things can't ever change. Even though Dance is a machine, she has learned a lot from him. She's a better soldier because of him. The irony is that this dangerous synth machine, who was so dangerous that he must be executed, has strengthened the Brotherhood and its soldiers at every opportunity.
Dance is the most selfless person I've ever met. I've watched him risk his own life based on nothing more than principle alone.
Is not compassion a worthy virtue?
Give him a chance. Let him tell his side of the story. If you're not convinced by what he says, or somehow he's become truly lost to us, then you do what you have to do.
What we have to do is not follow orders given to us by a lunatic.
She's making a whole lot more sense than Maxon did.
When you make it to Listening Point Bravo, you find the bunker lightly defended by a couple of turrets and a few Protectrons. Deep inside, we find Paladin Dance outside of his power armor in a fateful mindset.
Why didn't you tell me, Dance?
Because I didn't know. Until Quinlan got that list decoded, I thought synths were the enemy. I never expected to hear that I was one of them.
How could you not know that you're a synth?
It doesn't make sense to me either. It just feels like a cruel joke. I remember being a child. I remember growing up in the ruins, everything. I suppose they programmed that all into my head. I mean, I feel like I've been in control of my entire life, making my own decisions and determining my own fate. Even though the proof states I'm a synth, I don't feel any different than I did before. I still feel like a human.
Now, you can simply fulfill Elder Maxon's command and execute him here.
Maxon's ordered you to execute me, and I'll be damned if I'm going to stand in your way.
If it needs to be done, then so be it.
I've never been prouder of you than I am right now, sister. It's been a pleasure serving with you.
Victorium, sister.
If you choose this option, you finish the quest, and you can leave the bunker with the dog tags and return to Elder Maxon to continue on the Brotherhood of Steel questline. At this time, you can also refuse to kill him, and he will instead commit suicide.
So, what are your orders? Does Maxon even want me alive?
Of course not. Since of the enemy, remember?
All too well. Look, I'm not blind to the fact that we're good friends, and this must be very difficult for you. I wish Maxon had sent someone else, but that doesn't change a thing. I'm a synth, which means I need to be destroyed. If you disobey your orders, you're not only betraying Maxon, you're betraying the Brotherhood of Steel and everything it stands for. Synths can't be trusted. Machines were never meant to make their own decisions. They need to be controlled. Technology that's run amok is what brought the entire world to its knees, and humanity to the brink of extinction. I need to be the example, not the exception.
If you're so eager to die, then do it yourself.
If you leave here without completing your orders, then I'll carry them out for you.
I suppose this is one way you can go through with it without actively murdering Dance. The other option is to convince him that he doesn't deserve death. Now, this goes against everything he currently believes as a Brotherhood of Steel soldier, and it goes against everything that the Brotherhood stands for. You're given three arguments, all of which have the same effect.
You need to face this, Dance. Dying is the coward's way out. I've already lost my family. I don't want to lose my friend.
But the one that I think is the most compelling is the one that demonstrates that even though he is a synth, even though he is a machine, he knows that he is no threat to the Brotherhood. He knows that he's not a threat to humanity, and he knows that he's not dangerous.
You're the proof that Maxon's wrong. You're a synth, but everything you've done has been for the good of mankind.
You're right. How could I have been so blind? I'm not technology that's gone out of control. I've been a benefit to mankind, not its downfall.
Choosing that option causes a light to go on in Dance's head. oh, she's right. I know myself, I know my motives, I know where my heart is, and I'm for the Brotherhood. And yet I'm a synth, but I'm not a threat to the Brotherhood. And I'm not a threat to humanity. He gets it.
Now, come on. Let's get the hell out of here.
Once you've convinced him that he shouldn't die, keeping him from killing himself, you now have to find a place for him to go, and he proposes to leave the Commonwealth forever. But as you leave the bunker, you are confronted by Elder Maxon.
How dare you betray the Brotherhood?
It's not her fault. It's mine.
I'll deal with you in a moment. Knight, why has this thing not been destroyed? Dance isn't a man. It's a machine. An automaton created by the Institute. It wasn't born from the womb of a loving mother. It was grown within the cold confines of a laboratory. Flesh is flesh. Machine is machine. The two were never meant to intertwine. By attempting to play God, the Institute has taken the sanctity of human life and corrupted it beyond measure.
After all I've done for the Brotherhood, all the blood I've spilled in our name, how can you say that about
me? You're the physical embodiment of what we hate most. Technology that's gone too far. Look around you, Dance. Look at the scorched earth and the bones that litter the wasteland. Millions, perhaps even billions, died because science outpaced man's restraint. They called it a new frontier and pushing the envelope, completely disregarding the repercussions. Can't you see the same thing is happening again? You're a single bomb in an arsenal of thousands, preparing to lay waste to what's left of mankind.
You're comparing Dance to a nuclear bomb.
This machine might not be a bomb, but its goal is exactly the same. Place it where you want the damage done, and when you least expect it, it delivers a lethal blow without warning and without mercy. A precision strike delivered right at the heart of the enemy.
You know what? Maxon has a point. Who's to say that the Institute didn't program Paladin Dance to snap like the synth did during the Broken Mask incident and suddenly kill all of the Brotherhood of Steel soldiers on the Pridwin? Who's to say that there isn't some special code like the recall code that can be spoken to Paladin Dance to turn him into an assassin? Paladin Dance really does exhibit a security risk, at least until the Institute is gone. Once the Institute is gone, there is no longer a puppeteer at the strings. Once the Institute is gone, there is no one left in control of the synths. And also, there's that bit I mentioned at the beginning. How can we trust the data we got from the Institute? What if it's wrong? What if it was planted to make Dance look like a synth, but he's really not? I mean, if you kill Dance, you do find a synth component, so yes, he is a synth, but the only way to find that out is by killing him. And you certainly can't do that to everybody you suspect is a synth, otherwise you're killing a whole lot of people. So why take the Institute's data at face value? Why does the Brotherhood believe it? Wouldn't it be more prudent to take the appropriate precautions, but without doing something drastic like killing Dance? I'm willing to admit that there's a legitimate argument that synths are dangerous and they have the potential to greatly harm the Brotherhood of Steel. But where I disagree with Arthur Maxon is not only his world philosophy that synths are just machines, no better than a ham radio, with manufactured souls, but I also disagree with the way he resolves this situation. You could resolve it peacefully. Paladin Dance is clearly a loyal member of the Brotherhood. Say what you want about Dance's personality, but he is loyal to his friends, he is loyal to his brothers, he is completely selfless in the face of danger, and he is self-sacrificial. There are few people who are like that. I am not like that. I respect and admire people like Dance, who are so selfless that they're willing to give themselves up for the people they love, for the people they're protecting, and for the good of humanity. Instead of executing Dance and making an example out of him, they could have put him in quarantine. They could have found a way to use his expertise, to use his intimate knowledge of the Commonwealth, to continue to serve the Brotherhood of Steel. They could have used this moment as a moment to reflect. As the soul survivor says, Paladin Dance's flesh and blood evidence that Arthur Maxon is wrong.
How can you trust the word of a machine that thinks it's alive? A machine that's had its mind erased, its thoughts programmed, its very soul manufactured. Those ethics that it's striving to champion aren't even its own. They were artificially inserted in an attempt to have it blend into society.
It's true. I was built within the confines of a laboratory, and some of my memories aren't my own. But when I saw my brothers dying at my feet, I felt sorrow. When I defeated an enemy of the Brotherhood, I felt pride. And when I heard your speech about saving the Commonwealth, I felt hope. Don't you understand? I thought I was human, Arthur. From the moment I was taken in by the Brotherhood, I've done absolutely nothing to betray your trust, and I never will.
It's too late for that now.
I agree with the Brotherhood that science run amok is a danger for humanity, but I don't think that the logical conclusion of that is that any science that the Brotherhood thinks is too advanced needs to be destroyed. Instead, it needs to be better understood and used responsibly. The fact that Dance is still a diehard Brotherhood of Steel soldier who believes in the cause just as much as a synth as he did as a human proves that not all advanced technology is dangerous, that not all advanced technology needs to be destroyed. The problem I have with Arthur Maxson and his Brotherhood of Steel is how fanatical they have become. It's one thing to have a world philosophy that science run amok leads to technology that can be very dangerous, that when humans tamper with nature using nuclear fission or the FEV virus, that bad things can happen, and so we need to be very careful with how we use science. That's totally fine. But when you take it a step further and you refuse to see the humanity in sentient supermutants, in non-feral ghouls, in Gen 3 synths who don't even know that they are synths, then your fanaticism has blinded you to basic human ethics, which opens the door for you to commit atrocities both towards humanity and beyond. Here, there are three possible results to your choices. The first is to agree with Maxson, to be convinced by him, and to execute Dance. Dance will not protest, and he goes down in one hit.
The Institute has foolishly chosen to grant you life. You simply should not exist. I don't intend to debate this any longer. My orders stand.
For the good of the Brotherhood, he needs to die.
Finally, you've come to your senses. You may proceed. Night.
Dance did nothing to deserve
Victorian, sister.
The second is to admit that Dance poses a threat, but to request that Maxson kill Dance himself. You just don't have it in you.
For the good of the Brotherhood, he needs to die. But I won't pull the trigger myself.
I'm disappointed in you, Knight. Stand aside.
If you do, Maxson pulls out a knife.
Disgusting machine. Let this serve as an example to the Institute.
Dance kneels execution style, and Maxson slits his throat.
Victorium, sister.
I can't believe you just stood by and let Maxson murder your friend. Synth or not, he deserved better from you.
What kind of human being do you have to be to murder a man with a knife without flinching? Especially a man who is loyal to you and who follows you and who believes exactly the same way you do. You have to be a fanatic. You have to be so wrapped up in your pet cause that you were blind to the basic ethics of humanity. Because that's what pet causes do to people. Pet causes turn people into fanatics. Pet causes make them blind to the ethics of basic humanity. Only then can you commit atrocities without blinking. And that's what Maxson just did. The third option is to pass a charisma check to convince Arthur Maxson to spare Paladin Dance.
After all the sacrifices I've made, and all the battles I've fought for the Brotherhood, you need to listen to me. You owe me that much.
Very well. I'm listening.
Whether he's human or not, Dance saved the lives of countless Brotherhood soldiers. Now it's time you saved his.
You're a stubborn woman. So, it appears we've arrived at an impasse. Allowing Dance to live undermines everything the Brotherhood stands for. Yet you insist that he remains alive, which leaves me with only a single alternative. Dance, as far as I'm concerned, you're dead. You were pursued and slain by this Brotherhood Knight, and your remains were incinerated. From this day forward, you are forbidden to set foot on the Pridwin, or speak to anyone from the Brotherhood of Steel. Should you choose to ignore me, know you'll be fired upon. Immediately. Do we understand each other?
I do. Thank you for believing in me, Arthur.
Don't mistake my mercy for acceptance. The only reason you're still alive is because of her.
I'm returning.
Now, I've always been surprised that this was even an option. Why is this an option? If Elder Maxon is so fanatical that he's gonna slit the throat of a man who has served him faithfully for over a decade, why would he allow for his principles to be challenged, his mind to be changed by a sole survivor whom he's known for just a few weeks or months? This part of the quest is the part that seems unrealistic to me. I don't think Arthur Maxon would allow for this, but I think Bethesda had to program it to allow players to feel like they could still side with the Brotherhood, which in my opinion defeats the entire purpose of the Blind Betrayal quest. The point of Blind Betrayal is to force the player to come to terms with the fact that if you really do believe that all Gen 3 synths are just toasters, that all Gen 3 synths are machines that need to be destroyed, then that belief applies to all synths, even those whom you've grown to know and love. It's the moment in the game where the player is challenged to reconsider the prejudices that the developers have encouraged you to embrace thus far in the game. But by giving you a way out, by giving you an option that spares Dance's life, without challenging Arthur Maxon and the fanatical beliefs of the Brotherhood, I think is a bit of a cop-out, and that's a bummer to me. I wish this was not an option, but it is. If you choose this option, Paladin Dance stays at Listening Post Bravo. You return to the Pridwin, and Arthur Maxon gives you Paladin Dance's full suit of power armor, and you finally get your player home aboard the Pridwin.
His quarters and all his possessions are now yours, including his personal suit of power armor. Congratulations, Paladin.
Body's not even cold, and you're already dividing the loot?
To the victor go the spoils. Being a part of the Brotherhood, you should learn to appreciate that sentiment.
Interestingly, you can kill Arthur Maxon to prevent him from killing Dance. If you do, Dance turns on you. I mean, talk about being a diehard Brotherhood of Steel soldier. Even when you destroy Dance's murderer, saving his life, he turns on you because you just compromised the Brotherhood. After you defeat the Institute, and you go back to Scribe Halen at the Cambridge police station, you learn that she has been taking good care of a man she greatly respects and admires, Paladin Dance.
Look, I never really had a chance to thank you for sparing Dance. I visited him a few times at the bunker. He really seems to be doing well. Well, it's hard to tell when he's happy, but you get what I mean.
You've gone out there?
Dance is isolated. He doesn't have much in the way of supplies or ammunition, so I bring him whatever he needs. And when he isn't partnered up with you, I think he needs someone else to spend time with. Don't worry, I'm not implying you're neglecting him out there. By defying Maxon's orders, you've already done more than enough.
You're the one who convinced me to spare his life.
But you're the one that had the courage to follow through with it. I knew there was something special about you when you stumbled into our compound and helped us take down those ferals. And everything you've done since then for Dance, for the Brotherhood, even for yourself, has proved me right.
I found this to be a really warm and touching moment in the game. I wish there was an option for Dance and Hayden to become a couple, but I suppose Bethesda didn't put that in the game because there is an option for you to romance Paladin Dance, and they didn't want a romantic triangle or conflict of interest appearing in the game. Plus, there is something to be said for admiration and friendship outside of romance, so I guess I'm fine with this the way it is. Strangely enough, even though Dance attacks you for killing Arthur Maxon, after you defeat the Institute, if you go back to Dance and talk to him about it, he has unique dialogue options.
So, it appears the Commonwealth is about to enter a new era of peace thanks to you.
But if you try to give the credit to the Brotherhood, Dance is almost dismissive.
Joining the Brotherhood of Steel was the right thing to do for the Commonwealth.
It doesn't matter.
He respects you as a friend and loves you for saving his life. But it seems that as his exile has gone on, the Brotherhood has left a little bit of a bad taste in his mouth. Now, if you use Bethesda's archive extractor to open up the sound files in the game, you find unused sound clips for a possible fourth ending to the Blind Betrayal quest. In this ending, Paladin Dance convinces you to take him aboard the Pridwin and challenge Arthur Maxon for eldership of the Brotherhood.
I was weighing my options before you got here, and I might have a way out for both of us. When Halen warned me about Quinlan's discovery, she begged me to confront Maxon. She told me that there were Brotherhood soldiers that still believed in me, that would stand behind me if I challenged his authority. At the time, I told her that it wouldn't be right to cause a rift in our ranks. We're on the brink of war with the Institute, and weakening our unity felt like I'd be backstabbing my own troops. But knowing that you're still with me, maybe that will be enough to convince Maxon that he's making a mistake. I'll come back to the Pridwin with you, and we'll confront Maxon together.
Apparently there's some old Brotherhood code that allows one Brotherhood soldier to challenge the Elder for leadership. It reminds me a lot of the ending to the Kevin Costner movie, The Postman, which was a pretty silly movie. Maybe that's why they didn't use it. Ultimately, if Arthur Maxon is defeated, you, the sole survivor, become Elder of the Brotherhood.
As a Brotherhood of Steel Paladin, I'm issuing a formal challenge against your authority as Elder. We'll settle this matter as it was written in the Litany. In combat. I want to make one thing clear to everyone. This body might be synth, but my heart and mind belong to the Brotherhood. The Institute is still a tremendous threat to the Commonwealth. They possess technologies that need to be confiscated or destroyed. And even if that means I have to pull the trigger on my own kind, I'm willing to make that sacrifice. You've come such a long way in a short amount of time, so I can understand how you feel. All I can promise is that I'll be by your side every step of the way. I hope that's enough to convince you to take your place as Elder of the Brotherhood. The litany's clear. We have a new Elder. So, what are your orders?
So they toyed with an ending to this quest that left you, the sole survivor, in charge of the entire Brotherhood of Steel, which allowed Paladin Dance, the synth, to lead the Brotherhood of Steel in war against the Institute. I'm so disappointed that they cut this from the game. This is the one ending to the Brotherhood of Steel plotline that I think could potentially be morally right, because a lot of the issues that the Brotherhood have stem from Arthur Maxon himself. The Brotherhood of Steel is a completely redeemable faction, if not for Arthur's fanaticism. We know that the Midwest Brotherhood of Steel, which we're introduced to in Fallout Tactics, doesn't hold the same prejudices as the East Coast Brotherhood of Steel. They have a wide range of sentient creatures among its ranks. They don't just admit humans. We remember from Fallout 3 that Elder Lyons was more concerned with getting pure water to the people living in the Capital Wastelands than upholding the Brotherhood's vision of species purity. This is why the outcasts left the Brotherhood of Steel. They felt that the Brotherhood under Elder Lyons had lost its soul. Now, I'll be getting into this more when I do my video on whether or not the Brotherhood of Steel is evil, but I'll sum up by saying that I wish that they had included this option, because it would have allowed Paladin Dance to remain a soldier of the Brotherhood of Steel, and that's really where the bulk of his identity as a human being is wrapped up. And it would have allowed you to, in my opinion, redeem the Brotherhood of Steel. But sadly, that is not an option in the game. I think they probably cut it because Bethesda wanted to keep morality gray. There's really no good option in the Blind Betrayal quest and the whole Brotherhood of Steel questline. There's no satisfactory ending there. No matter what you choose, something bad happens. If you choose to remain loyal to the Brotherhood of Steel, Paladin Dance dies. If you choose to protect Paladin Dance, he is exiled from the Brotherhood and he is now kill on sight for the entire faction. It's just kind of unsatisfying, which we've come to expect from Bethesda and their games. I had similar feelings with the ending to Far Harbor. So at the beginning of this video, I said that the morality of your decisions in this quest really depended upon whether or not you thought synths were machines or people. Now, I did an entire other video on whether or not synths are people, and in that video, I tried to make the argument that yes, they are. But I'll sum up by saying that Proctor Quinlan dismissed synths by comparing them to ham radios, and clearly they are more advanced than ham radios. It's a horrible comparison. It's an insulting comparison. It denies the reality that we see in the game of synths having complicated emotions, complicated feelings, and genuine beliefs, like Paladin Dance. It almost turns that which is humanity into some sort of magical human sauce that only humans that evolved, humans that were born from a womb, are gifted with. And calling synths machines is also denying the reality. There is very little machine in a synth. The bulk of a synth is comprised of human genetic material. Yes, it is grown in a lab. Emphasis on the word grown. Machines are not grown. Machines are built. Humans are grown. Organic material is grown. DNA is grown. The fact that Arthur Maxon detected that Dance was a synth because his DNA matched a DNA sample found in the Institute is evidence enough that he is more than just a machine. He has DNA, which are the building blocks of life. Human DNA, which is the core programming of a human.
Your thoughts?
Time and time again, scientific understanding is at odds with basic morality. Dance has served the Brotherhood well. Why should it matter if he's a synth or not?
Gen 3 synths are far more than just machines, just toasters, just ham radios. And the Brotherhood is being willfully ignorant by saying otherwise. That is why I think that Gen 3 synths are people. They may not be human, but they are people. And because of that, I think it is morally wrong to execute Paladin Dance. But that is just one man's humble opinion, and I know this is going to be a controversial conversation in the comment section below, but I can't wait to read what you guys have to say. Let me know your thoughts in the comment section below. I do read all of them, I respond to many of them, and I use your comments as inspiration for my future videos. Stay tuned for my big finale to this series on Brotherhood of Steel videos, where I'm going to go over whether or not the Brotherhood of Steel is evil. I think you can guess where I fall on the issue. If you like this video and you want to support me in a more personal way, consider becoming one of my patrons on Patreon. Patreon subscribers gain access to my private Discord server, as well as a bunch of other cool Oxhorn perks. But more than anything, ladies and gentlemen, I'm just so glad that you're here watching this video with me today. Thank you so much for watching from the bottom of my heart, and I'll see you tomorrow morning bright and early with a brand new video.